So why don't we start with, and again, well, I've got these up here just to help us mentally categorize these things. So in terms of the non-invasive enhancing procedures, laser trabeculoplasty. Now, Argon laser trabeculoplasty has been around for a few decades. Lasers have been available clinically for use since the 1970s. And Argon laser trabeculoplasty really has kind of a neat history. It's one of those of many medical advances that were really kind of stumbled upon, okay? So when lasers first came out, everybody thought they were really cool because they made holes, right? You made a hole in anything you wanted to make a hole in. And they made holes when you bounced them off a mirror in the trabecular meshwork. Well, geez, isn't this obvious? Make a bunch of little holes in the trabecular meshwork, get flow into the canal, out the collector channel system, we're good to go. So they tried that in monkeys, and sure enough, they made holes. But then what happens in the eye as well as anywhere else when you make a hole or an incision where it shouldn't be? Scarred down, closed up. So then they said, well, the holes aren't working. But you know what? If we laser these monkeys' trabecular meshwork, not quite enough to make a hole, just enough to coagulate it, to melt it a bit, it actually results in the pressure going up. So now we've got a monkey model of glaucoma. How great is that? Well, now we can induce glaucoma in monkeys, and now we can study other treatments on these monkeys. So they took a failure, and they created a laboratory success. Except the monkey, this is one of those and then stories, it just keeps going. Except it turns out that some of these monkeys who had enough laser therapy to coagulate, but not enough to penetrate, actually ended up with their pressures going down after the initial post-operative inflammatory response. So some bright scholar, scientist, researcher said, well, wait a second. Pressure went down. Something's going on. This could actually be a treatment for glaucoma. So they titrated it down a little bit more. Not quite enough to, make a big coagulative mess, but enough to make some structural change. And lo and behold, ALT, argon laser trabeculoplasty, was discovered. It was really stumbled upon. And to this date, we really don't know how it works. There's all these theories about, it stretches the trabecular meshwork in between the spots, or it actually creates microscopic openings or tears. Nobody really knows. It works well for open-angle glaucoma. It can be performed in 1 to 2 sessions. But the problem is it does still result in microscopic scars. Also may limit future surgeries, right? So surgeries that involve opening up that Schlemm's canal, it can actually be problematic because now you've got these scars that are essentially sealing the canal. So surgeries such as canaloplasty and potentially some of the newer surgeries that are not yet available could be limited by argon laser trabeculoplasty. So more recently, in the 1990s, Dr. Latina developed selective laser trabeculoplasty. Now, it's called selective laser trabeculoplasty because the laser is selectively absorbed by pigment, so the melanin granules in the trabecular meshwork. And the neat thing about it is that it only uses 1% of the energy of argon laser trabeculoplasty and does not cause coagulative damage. So because it doesn't cause any coagulative damage, it doesn't limit future surgeries, it doesn't cause any kind of PAS, and we've all seen aggressive peripheral anterior synechiae, I call them sawtooth, PAS. When somebody's had aggressive ALT in the past, you look under gonio and you can see these little sawteeth. You won't see that with selective laser trabeculoplasty. And because it doesn't cause any damage, it can actually be repeated. So it works about 70% of the time, works about as well as a drop, which is also about as well as argon laser trabeculoplasty works. So it's not really any better in terms of how effective it is, but it's repeatable and it doesn't close future doors. So selective laser trabeculoplasty, when it first came out, was crazy expensive. It was a one-trick pony laser, so not too many people are going to be buying it. Not too many people did. So some companies developed another technology called micropulse laser technology, or MLT, micropulse laser trabeculoplasty, and this essentially segments the pulses into these tiny little super fast pulses. And by doing so, you don't get the heat, you don't get the increase in temperature, so you don't get coagulative damage. And there's less damage and scarring, but you get the same kind of result as you would with SLT or argon laser trabeculoplasty, at least according to the company documents. There just aren't as many good studies on this. This probably would have been something that would have taken over, and we would have seen a lot more of that, except that now the SLT patent has just expired, and so companies are now coming out with SLTs that are significantly less expensive than $70,000. So this may go by the wayside, this MLT.